bit about what adopting the school means.
Yeah. So every year since I've started the foundation, we've always tried to adopt the school. And in that effort, what that means is I come to the school once a month. And I think this year, what we're really structuring our once a month classes around is financial literacy, right? And so how can I bring a lot of what I know to the generation of kids that are preparing themselves for college? So, you know, debt, credit card, balancing, checkbooks, checks, just in general, how to do all of these things just to enhance and prepare them when they go to college not to fall in some of the traps that are in college as far as the kids battle with.
So why this school then? What stood out about this school specifically?
Principal Davis is really committed to this school, and he's really changed the school around from the history of what it used to be. He's really educated the staff that he's had. He's upgraded a lot of the things that they really have here. And from that instance, it just, when I seen his passion for what he wanted to bring to the kids, it just made me feel like this is what we needed to be.
Yeah. So obviously the heart story is well known, but what's the motivation behind the financial literacy side of it? Where does that kind of come from?
Is that a
need that's out there?
I feel like it's a big need. I feel like when you go to college, they don't teach you about how to be financially stable in a sense. They don't teach you about these small, intricate details that are a big part of our lives. Credit is a big part of our lives, and if you ask a student now who's preparing themselves for college, they probably wouldn't know what his credit score really was and how it's determined and things like that, what affects it. And I think that this is something that the younger generation in our world really, really needs today. And so any way that we can empower them and give them the knowledge that allows them to be even more prepared for life after college and going into college.
So what's your role directly going to be then? Are you coming out here?
I'm coming out here personally myself. Yeah. On my off days or on times that I can dedicate about an hour or two, I'll be out here myself bringing worksheets. We're going to be doing diagrams within class, and it's going to be a personal session. And we like to try and prepare most of the kids that are going off to college, because I feel like these are the things that they're going to really need to understand it. And if they can learn one or two things here and there, it'll really help them in my eyes. Because when I went to college, I didn't know how to write a check, right? I didn't know the importance of credit scores. I didn't know what affected the credit score, right? You get an apartment, you put the water bill in your name. You don't know that those things affect your credit. So just preparing them for those little things.
Now, did you adopt the school last year too?
Yeah, so last year we did a little bit of integrating the system and some of the things that we did for the last generation of the seniors that they had. And then this year now is a full adoption mode, right? This is something that now we're dedicating once a month, like I said, sessions. My wife actually will be partaking in some of the sessions with the females at the school as well, to try and enhance their abilities in certain areas and needs that they may need. So it's a full lesson that I feel like we as athletes have the platform to really give knowledge to the younger generation, and I feel like it's our duty.
The free heart screenings too, obviously. That's something that, I mean, look, a lot of high school kids aren't thinking about that. A lot of adults aren't even thinking about that.
Right.
So, I mean, what does that kind of do for this community to have those available?
You know, I want to say is we want to take away as much stress that families have, right? And, you know, typically these heart screenings that you go to doctors, they cost upwards of a couple hundred dollars, right? MCOR provides them for roughly $70 to $80. And in that effort, we felt like it was our duty to sponsor as many as we could for the year. And so, you know, I chose the number 38 because of my number and the importance behind it. And with that, hopefully that gives enough families the incentive to say, okay, let me sign up and just see if everything's okay. And it can be for athletes or just the normal student, the normal person that just want to make sure everything's okay. And so I felt like I said, it's my duty to do that thing.